Welcome to the installation of the second bishop of the Diocese of Tyler, the Most Reverend Bishop Edmond Carmody. I'm Maria Hilda Piñon with Catholic Television in San Antonio, joining with Omega Media Ministries for the Diocese of Tyler to bring you coverage for this event. Bishop Carmody comes to us from San Antonio, having served as auxiliary for the Archdiocese since his episcopal ordination on December the 15th, 1988. In March of this year, His Holiness John Paul II selected him to take the place of the late Bishop Charles Hrsic. He will now be the second bishop of the Diocese of Tyler that was established in 1989. I hope you will join us for the Liturgy of Installation, which is now taking place inside the Oil Palace here in Tyler, Texas.
Thank you. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you. On September the 7th, 1991, Almighty God called unto himself Bishop Charles Hersick of happy memory, the first shepherd of this new diocese of Tyler. Immediately thereafter, the process was begun to follow the process and to find the replacement for the deceased shepherd. I would like to first invite you to pause for a moment to remember in a special way our brother of happy memory, Bishop Charles Hersick. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, let perpetual light shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Will you please be seated? At this moment, I call the consultors of the Diocese of Tyler to the sanctuary for the presentation and reading of the apostolic letter appointing the new shepherd of this diocese.
Reverend John Brennan, Reverend Harold Paulson, Reverend Gerald Priest, Reverend James Young, and Reverends Maurice Linehan.
I now call on Monsignor Milan Joseph, the administrator of the diocese, to present the apostolic letter to the consultors and to read it to the community here present.
Bull of appointment of Most Reverend Edmond Carmody as Bishop of the Diocese of Tyler in Texas. John Paul, Bishop, Servant of the Servants of God. To our venerable brother Edmond Carmody, up to the present titular Bishop of Mortlock and Auxiliary Bishop of the Archdiocese of San Antonio, now selected as the Bishop of the See of Tyler, health and apostolic benediction. Although at the present time we are engaged in many official duties and the conduct of many affairs, in no way do we neglect to think of the individual churches for whose spiritual well-being we have undertaken a very special responsibility. We have in mind now the Church of Tyler and that community of the faithful, which we perceive to be lacking a shepherd and truly desiring one, following upon the much lamented passing of our venerable brother, Charles E. Hersick. It seems to us, however, venerable brother, that because of your experience in the office of bishop, you are well prepared to undertake this ministry and to fulfill it fruitfully. With the favorable vote, therefore, of the Congregation for Bishops, exercising our apostolic authority, we transfer you to the See of Tyler with all the rights attached to your dignity and pertaining to your appointment as described in the sacred canons, having freed you from all connection with the titular see of Mortlach, as well as the office of Auxiliary Bishop of San Antonio. Although you are exempted from repeating the profession of faith, you will nevertheless once more take the oath of fidelity to us and to our successors in office, according to the required formula, and you will see to it that the same, signed and sealed, is forwarded to the Congregation for Bishops in timely fashion. The clergy and faithful, all of whom we encourage to an even greater fervor for the future, are to be informed of your appointment. And finally, a few years ago, we already gave evidence of our goodwill toward you and our confidence in you. We now wish to repeat these sentiments, and fully conscious of your being strengthened by heavenly graces, to affirm with great assurance that you will discharge this high office for the health and prosperity of that portion of the Lord's flock. Given in Rome at St. Peter's, the 24th day of March, in the year of our Lord, 1992, the 14th of our pontificate. John Paul II, Pope.
Additionally, I received the following letter. His Excellency, Most Reverend Patrick F. Flores, Metropolitan Archbishop of San Antonio. The Congregation for Bishops takes pleasure in advising Your Excellency that the Supreme Pontiff John Paul II, by Divine Providence Pope, assigned to the Church of Tyler, which is subject to your metropolitan authority, a new bishop and pastor, one whose singular merit provides genuine hope for the future well-being of the people of God, His Excellency, the Most Reverend Edmond Carmody. Up to this time, titular bishop of Mortlach and auxiliary of the Archdiocese of San Antonio. Wherefore, the same congregation praying for God's bountiful favor in your behalf ask that in a spirit of brotherly love, you receive the new suffragan bishop as one appointed to membership in the body of bishops in the hierarchy of the Catholic Church, and that if it should request your help and counsel from your own pastoral skills, you should assist him towards a more efficacious fulfillment of the office entrusted to him for the benefit of his diocese. Given at Rome from the office of the Congregation for Bishops, March 25th, 1992, and signed by Bernardine Cardinal Gantin, Prefect, and Archbishop Justin Regali, Secretary. To witness this beautiful event, we have all of you beautiful and great and wonderful people. But we have some very special guests on this particular night, all the way from the country of Ireland. And the first person I would like to ask to stand is the mother, Mama Carmody, who is right here. There are also three brothers that came to join us from Ireland. Will you please stand, the Carmody's? one sister, and she's a Sister of Mercy. Sister, will you please stand? Okay. And four sister-in-laws are here today. Will you please stand?
There's got to be persons here as well.
And the new bishop comes from a very large family, so there are many other heretics that are present here for this beautiful occasion. Bishop Carmody, you have heard the letters of His Holiness John Paul II. You are called by the Holy Spirit in the Church to serve Almighty God and the people of the Diocese of Tyler in faith and love as their shepherd. Are you willing to accept this diocese in the tradition of the apostolic faith of our church?
With faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, and with the love of God in my heart, I do accept the pastoral care of the people of God in the Diocese of Tyler. I resolve to serve faithfully the church in this diocese.
We invite all of you to stand and join me in praying. Look down, O God, our protector, upon the face of your anointed. Send help to him, Lord, from your holy place, from Zion be his protection. Now let the enemy prevail against him. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let our cry come to you.
Let us pray. O God, Shepherd and ruler of the faithful, look with favor upon your servant, Edmond, whom you have appointed pastor of the Church of Tyler. Grant that by word and example, he may assist those over whom he is placed, so that he and the flock entrusted to his care may together attain everlasting life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. It gives me great pleasure to lead you to the Apostolic Chair of Tyler.
Let us join our voices and sing praise and thanks to the Lord. God our Father, you will that all people be saved and come to the knowledge of your truth. Send workers into your great harvest, that the gospel may be preached to every creature, and your people, gathered together by the word of life and strengthened by the power of the sacraments, may advance in the way of salvation and love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. When you make a loan of any kind to your neighbor, you shall not enter your neighbor's house to receive the pledge, but wait outside until the one to whom you are making the loan brings the pledge outside to you. If your neighbor is poor, you shall not sleep in the mantle given as pledge, but shall return it at sunset, so your neighbor may sleep in it. Then you will be blessed, and it will be a good deed of yours before the Lord your God. You shall not defraud a poor and needy hired servant, whether he be one from your own country or one of the aliens who live in your communities. You shall pay your servant each day's wages before sundown on the day itself, since he is poor and looks forward to them. Otherwise, he will cry to the Lord against you, and you will be held guilty. When you reap the harvest in your field and overlook a sheaf there, you shall not go back to it. Let it be for the alien, the orphan, or the widow, that the Lord your God may bless you in all your undertakings. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. Lectura de la carta de Pablo a los Romanos. Que el amor sea sincero, aborrezcan el mal y cuiden todo lo bueno. En el amor entre hermanos, demuéstrense cariño unos a otros. En el respeto, estimen a los otros como más dignos. En el cumplimiento del deber, no sean flojos. En el espíritu sean fervorosos y sirvan al Señor. Tengan esperanza y estén alegres en las pruebas. Sean pacientes, oren en todo tiempo. Con los creyentes necesitados, compartan con ellos. Con los que estén de paso, sean solícitos para recibirles en sus casas. Bendigan a quien les persigan, bendigan y no maldigan. Alégrense con los que están alegres, lloren con los que lloran. Vivan en armonía unos con otros, no busquen las grandezas, sino que vayan a lo humilde. No se tomen por unos sabios. No devuelvan a nadie mal por mal. Procuren ganarse el aprecio de todo el mundo. Hagan todo lo posible en cuanto de ustedes dependa para vivir en paz con todos. Esta es palabra de Dios.
Aleluya, aleluya, aleluya. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been reared, and entering the synagogue on the Sabbath, as he was in the habit of doing, he stood up to do the reading. When the book of the prophet Isaiah was handed him, he unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, therefore he has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, recovery of sight to the blind, and release to prisoners, and to announce a year of favor from the Lord." And rolling up the scroll, he gave it back to the assistant and sat down. All in the synagogue had their eyes fixed on him. Then he began by saying to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." This is the gospel of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters in the Lord, I wish to thank each and every one of you for your presence here this evening, because the presence of each one of you adds joy and happiness to our celebration as we gather one family united in the Lord. I thank the Lord myself for the vocation that he has given to me to serve his holy people. And I have thanked him for 35 years for that vocation. Also, I am deeply moved and challenged by the confidence our Holy Father John Paul II has placed on me by appointing me Bishop of Tyler and giving me this special opportunity to serve the church in this area of the world. So to John Paul II, I pledge my prayers, my obedience, and my support. With this large crowd here this evening, I am certainly filled with joy because you have gathered here this evening to pray with me and pray for me and pray for the people of the Diocese of Tyler. And seeing the crowd from where I am, you are a marvelous crowd consisting of archbishops, bishops, priests, deacons, sisters, brothers, ministers, civic leaders, educators, leaders from other Christian traditions, friends of the Jewish faith, as well as all other religions. As I look out over this crowd, I see my dear personal friends from San Antonio, my friends and co-workers. And I want to assure you that I deeply love you and I shall truly miss you. Also in the crowd, my mother, my brothers, my sister, my sisters-in-law. And I want to say to you, I always appreciate your support and your affection. It is a source of strength to me. And at this time, I also want to say to my beloved father, who died in 1977, that I remember him with love and gratitude. And in this marvelous crowd here this evening, I want to say a special greeting to the people of the Diocese of Tyler. The priests and the deacons and the sisters and all of the people of this diocese, I want to say to you, for you I am a bishop, but with you I am a Christian. Also this evening, I want to pay sincere tribute and thanks to my good and dear friend, Bishop Charles Herzig, who was the first bishop of this diocese. And I think tonight we can all say to Bishop Herzig, rest in peace. Your flock is strong and growing. You have done well. You served us faithfully, and we thank you. From this holy assembly here, all of us gathered here under this one roof, I want to send my prayers and blessings to all the retired sisters, the retired brothers, the retired priests and laity who ministered to God's people in this part of the vineyard. So much that is great in this area of God's vineyard is due to the work of the retired people who served in this area. So we want to thank them tonight, not only for what they have done, but for what they are still doing by their prayers and good works. I also want to send my blessings and prayers to all those who are confined in hospitals in this diocese tonight, to those who are confined to nursing homes, to those who are sick in their own homes, and especially to those persons with disabilities who could not be with us tonight. I send you my love and my blessings. I also want to extend my hand in friendship as the Bishop of Tyler to all those in this area who do not believe in God, for those who follow no religion, those who are disenchanted, those who are angry, alienated, or hurt. We want to say we love you, we appreciate you, we join you in our efforts to respect all people. And I want to say to those in the many prisons in this diocese, I want to say to those who are in prison or those who are suffering in any way, I want to say, as the author of the letter to the Hebrews said, we remember you as though we were in prison with you. We remember you as though we were suffering with you. And to you, the people of the Diocese of Tyler, I want to pledge to you this evening that I intend to go from one end of this diocese to the other, from Texarkana to Buffalo, from Athens to Marshall, and all the cities in between. And this I intend to do between now and Christmas. And even though my brother bishops may say it's impossible, but I want to assure them there are only 42 parishes in the Tyler Diocese. It is possible. It will be done. Because I want to go to each and every parish, and I want to hear from you, the parishioners, what your vision is for your parish, and I want to know your mission. I want to hear your needs, and I want to share your dreams. I want to know your values and your goals for your community, because I want to be united with you as we strive to make the kingdom of the Lord Jesus more evident in our time. And I also want to say to all the Catholics of the Diocese of Tyler, let all of us join our hearts and hands with all people of goodwill, of all religions, all people who respect the life and dignity of the human person
and who promote the common good of the community. And I want to say to all of us, whatever our differences as believers may be, we all bow our heads to the same God. And let us not be discouraged by the smallness of our ecumenical steps, for we are moving forward. As Pope John Paul himself has asked, have we the right to turn back? And he goes on to say, dare we turn back simply because the road is difficult? So let us all join our hands and hearts in working for the Lord. My dear people, Almighty God has touched everything human in the incarnation of his divine Son, Jesus. St. Luke tells us in this evening's gospel that Jesus entered the synagogue in Nazareth. Jesus opened the scroll, and there he proclaimed his mission. He proclaimed that he came so that the blind could see, that is, those going astray could find their way, for he is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. He came so that the deaf could hear, so that those who do not know the good news of the Lord may hear it from us and through us. He came so that the lame could walk, so that those who are heavily burdened may be strengthened. For he has said, his yoke is easy and his burden is light. He came to set prisoners free, so that all those who are addicted may be relieved of their addiction. And Jesus proclaimed that all of us, you and I, are brothers and sisters. And tonight we are very proud that our ancestors have carried on that mission for hundreds of years. And in this, our country, we can thank the many heroic men and women. And we thank them with great gratitude for the efforts that they have conducted during these last 500 years. You and I together then can look forward with renewed commitment to continue the mission of the Lord Jesus, his work of evangelization, and we will continue that into the next century, into the next millennium, so that we too can leave a legacy of faith for generations yet to come. We, the church here in Tyler, we are called to continue the mission of Jesus, and the mission of Jesus challenges us to respond to the needs of the human family. In very practical terms, my friends, the church community, you and I have to deal with the pains of poverty, illness, ignorance, injustice, aimlessness, and lack of purpose and meaning in individual lives and society. You and I have to be a sensitive church, listening intently and moving courageously to heal the human hearts and bind the divided into one, for we are called to be witnesses of the Lord's mission. We as a church then are called to be a home where people belong and where people are called by name. And I call on all the parishes, all 42 of them here tonight, to remember you are the principal successors of the missions of East Texas, that you are truly evangelizing communities. I pray that you will be a family to one another, a family to those who are still in search of a religious family, to those who need a place to call their own. For your parish and our parishes are credible when it invites all people of all races and ethnic groups, of all social levels, to take their rightful place within the church and society, and that our parish family helps them to do so. We strive for a renewed world, renewed parishes, where there are no divisions, no partitions, or separations among people. So I call upon you parishioners in your parish communities to practice hospitality, where every person experiences hospitality, where even our first-time visitors experience acceptance and never leave our celebrations as strangers. Today, many of our brothers and sisters feel unanchored and uprooted. They need a place to land. And the Lord Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will refresh you." So let your parish be a home where everyone is welcomed, blessed, given the word of God, and a sign of peace. So my friends, throughout this 32 county area, remember, we are a compassionate church. We are called to be kind and merciful and helpful to all people, but especially to widows and orphans, foreigners and strangers. As we read today, the inspired author reminds us, be compassionate to each other, for you too were foreigners in another land. Remember, when we do not accept people, we reject them. And I think it is very interesting for us to recall here tonight the great apostolate of Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Here we have an elderly nun, nearly 80 years of age, with no systematic cure for poverty, no great cure for the ills of the world. And yet that simple woman electrifies the world because she offers the world what the world dearly needs today, compassion and love. Because compassion is not that plentiful in our time or in our world. So let us be compassionate to one another. Let us be a compassionate community, helping our sisters and brothers to realize that happiness is not found in the latest technological development or in any mind-changing drug. That happiness is found in a relationship with the Lord Jesus, the real compassionate shepherd, who draws every one of us into the Father's circle of love. So we are called then to reach out to one another as brothers and sisters. So our mission must go on. Our communities are called to be renewed. And we are called to be a community of linkage. And we link the rich and the poor, the men and the women, the powerful and the humble. And we need to link together in order to purify our world, in order to make the mission of the Lord Jesus more real in our time. So then this evening we are pledged to be a community dedicated to the life and respect of every human being. And that will be our focus, respect for the life and dignity of every human being from the womb to the tomb. So my dear friends, we accept our mission from the Lord Jesus. We are called to accept that mission. And we promise that we will work together, that we will strive with the help of the Lord to make that mission a reality in our time, so that we can pass on a more just world, a happier world, a world where we're all brothers and sisters. And that will be our goal, our legacy for future generations. So, mi querido pueblo, es un gran honor y placer venir a trabajar entre ustedes. El pueblo latinoamericano ha sido una gran alegría y fuente de vida para mí desde que yo fui a San Antonio, Texas, como sacerdote hace muchos años para trabajar en Guayaquil, Ecuador. Ahora espero con entusiasmo convivir, trabajar y celebrar con todos ustedes en esta diócesis de Tyler. Ustedes son mi pueblo y yo soy de ustedes. Gracias por sus grandes tesoros de tradición cristiana que ciertamente han enriquecido mi vida como hombre, sacerdote y ahora obispo. Ahora, por la gracia de Dios, vengo a ustedes como su pastor, el pastor que constantemente sale en búsqueda de las ovejas extraviadas, enfermas, necesitadas. El pastor que pregona la voz del Evangelio y continúa la acción de Jesús en el mundo de hoy. Quiero conocerles, escucharles, comprenderles y trabajar con ustedes y entre ustedes para el bien de nuestro pueblo. Creo que podemos y tenemos que trabajar juntos para eliminar todo tipo de miseria y violencia que existe entre nosotros. La justicia evangélica es la base de la paz y la mejor expresión de la caridad. Mientras hay pobres y abandonados entre nosotros, no podemos permanecer tranquilos. Yo quiero repetir, mientras hay pobres y abandonados entre nosotros, no podemos permanecer tranquilos. Jesús primero alimentó a las masas y después les predicó. La miseria más grande de nuestros días es la desaparición de la familia. Tenemos que hacer todo lo posible para fortalecer y promover el bien de la familia. Pues la buena familia es la base de la iglesia y de la sociedad. El Concilio Vaticano nos dice que la familia es la iglesia doméstica. Y ustedes, padres de familia, ustedes son los sacerdotes en su iglesia doméstica. Entonces ustedes tienen la vocación para entregar su fe a sus hijos. Entonces, padres de familia, ustedes deben portarse como sacerdotes para dar buen ejemplo a sus hijos. Una vocación muy especial. Entonces, los altarcitos y bendiciones del hogar son los más que influyen nuestro corazón. En cuanto desaparece la familia, aparece y crece la violencia. Nuestro pueblo hispano tiene una tradición de fe muy rica. Una tradición que este año cumple 500 años. Pero como toda tradición cristiana en los Estados Unidos, en Irlanda, en México, en Ecuador, en San Antonio, Texas, tiene que seguir siendo renovada y purificada constantemente por el Evangelio. Ahora yo quisiera desafiarles a celebrar con ánimo y júbilo con sus niños y ancianos, jóvenes y familias, las costumbres latinoamericanas de la fe, el bautismo de los niños, la primera comunión, las quinceañeras, los matrimonios, aniversarios y velorios, la fiesta de Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe, la fiesta del Sagrado Corazón, las posadas, miércoles de ceniza, Semana Santa, fiestas navideñas, Día de los Santos Reyes, Día de los Muertos y demás celebraciones religiosas. Tenemos una tradición muy rica, muy especial. La tradición es la base de nuestro existir latinoamericano, donde quiera que nos encontremos en el mundo. Ustedes son una gran bendición para nuestra diócesis. Mil gracias por su bienvenida tan calurosa. So tonight, to you, the people of the Diocese of Tyler, I say we have begun a new relationship, a new covenant. I, as your bishop, offer to you my service and leadership, my energies, my gifts, my mind, my heart, my strength, and my limitations. And so I offer all that I am to you to serve you. And I invite you to offer yourselves to each other in faith, in hope, and love. I ask you to accept your call from the Lord, your baptismal call, to be truly his disciples every day, in the church and in the marketplace. And let all of us walk together in the company of the Lord, so that all of us together can experience the joy of the Lord and have our hearts burning within us as we walk with him on our road of faith together. Blessings on you. Thank you.
Confidence in God's infinite love, let us pray.
Powerful God, look upon the needs of your people and instill in us the power to transform this world into your kingdom.
Yarab Barik Ahal Hazi Alrahia Wasadana Anachun Alamathal Alazi Khalakdana Ale.
Omnipotente, bendice a todos los ministros de nuestra diócesis quienes trabajan para edificar el reino de Dios.
Republic of the Philippines. Makapangyarihang Diyos, puspusan nawa kami ng walang hanggang biyaya upang ang lahat ng mga pumanaw, lalong-lalo na ang iyong sugod na si Bishop Charles Herzig, ay makaisa sa piling ng mga pinagpalat hinirang simbahan. Manalangin tayo sa Diyos.
Almighty ever-living God, your will for your people is that no one should be lost and that all should be saved. Hear the prayers of your people, guide the course of the world in your peace, and let your church serve you in tranquility and joy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please pray with me that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, look upon the face of Christ, your Son, who gave up his life to set all people free. Through him, may your name be praised among all peoples from east to west. And everywhere, may one sacrifice be offered to give you glory. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ, you bring us to the knowledge of your truth, that we may be united by one faith and one baptism to become his body. Through Christ, you have given the Holy Spirit to all peoples. How wonderful are the works of the Spirit, revealed in so many gifts. Yet how marvelous is the unity the Spirit creates from their diversity. As the Spirit dwells in the hearts of your children, filling the whole church with your presence and guiding it with wisdom, in our joy we sing to your glory with all the choirs of heaven. The fountain of all holiness, and let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread and the saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with John Paul, our Pope, Edmond, our bishop, me, your unworthy servant, all the bishops here present, the bishops of the world, all the clergy, and your beloved people. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
And through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Alla raccomandazione del Salvador e seguendo su divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir:
Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día, perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación, y líbranos del mal.
Líbranos, Señor, de todos los males, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo.
Tuyo es el reino, tuyo el poder y la gloria por siempre, Señor.
Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a los apóstoles, mi paz os dejo, mi paz os doy. No mires nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia, y conforme a tu palabra, concede la paz y la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz del Señor sea siempre con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Ahora podemos darnos ese signo de paz y de amor unos a los otros.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, and happy are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
At this time of Thanksgiving, I would not want this evening to end without making some comments of thanks. I think all of you know that this liturgy of installation has been beautifully done. In every detail, there has been nothing lacking. About 1 month before the announcement of Bishop Carmody's appointment to the Diocese of Tyler, a committee was appointed that would begin to do what we have done tonight, to make plans for this celebration. I would like to acknowledge them and ask you to join with me in thanking them. The committee consisted of Mary Sedbury, Robert Plochak, Linda Wallace, Sam Hall, Father Gavin Vavrick, Father Joe Strickland, Ed Lumen, and the chairman of the committee was Father Randy Martin. Along with this committee, the musicians, without which this celebration tonight would not have been what it has been. Diana Braque, Brian Braque, and Maria Labrada. I would like all of you to join with me in thanking the committee, in thanking the musicians, thanking all of the people in the Knights of Columbus, the Knights and Ladies of the Holy Sepulcher, those who have created banners and went through the trouble of being here, all of those persons from various parishes throughout this diocese, the 42 parishes and missions, who have come together to represent their communities. May we thank God for them, and may we thank them, please, with a round of applause.
And let us pray. Lord, you renew our life with this gift of redemption. Through this help to eternal salvation, may the true faith continue to grow throughout the world. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our celebration is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.